It is day 10 at the 28th Summer University Games here in Gwangju, Korea. Yesterday on day 9, a rainy day, but it didn't affect the quality of the competition. We'll look at athletics. Long jump dominated by the Russians. We have the gold medal match in women's football. France seeking their second straight gold. After a tough loss to the United States, Japan looks to win bronze in women's basketball. In volleyball, Russia looks for their fourth straight gold medal. We have four gold medal bouts from Taekwondo yesterday. We also have action from the racket sports. First in table tennis, and then also in badminton. The athletes at the Gwangju Universiad main stadium had a tough day dealing with all the elements. The rain and wind came through Gwangju with force, and it definitely affected some of the competitions. We'll first look at the women's javelin. This is Irina Sadeva of the Czech Republic. This is her first attempt, a throw of 59.89 meters, a new personal best for her. Next up, it's Lena Moos of Latvia. She's a former European under 23 champion. She loves that throw. She sees it come down. That'll come in at 60.26 meters. Now to the fifth attempt for Tatiana Kaladovich of Belarus. Her personal best is 63.61 meters. She wouldn't better that here today, but she will get 60.45, and that's good enough for gold. Moves is second, Sadeva wins the bronze. Now the men's long jump. You're looking here at Rudolf Pienaar of South Africa. He competed here in the triple jump, finishing 10th. This is his second attempt. And he'll mark a distance of 7.98 meters. Now on to the first of two Russians. This is Vasily Kopeikin. He heads down the runway. Here on his fourth attempt, 8.13 meters. He's even looking up at the scoreboard as he's coming through the air. A great jump there for Kopeikin. And now our other Russian in this competition. This is Pavel Shalin. And this is a jump of 8.29 meters. It's clean. And that jump there will give Shalin a gold medal here at Universiad.
Medal awarding ceremony.
Vasily Kopeikin wins silver, and Pienaar of South Africa takes the bronze. And now to the men's 4x100-meter relay. For South Africa, this features Akani Simbine. He won the gold medal in the men's 100 meters earlier this week. And you see them come down the back straight. Tough exchange there for the Russians in lane 8. And coming off the bend, it's close. Japan, though, here will pull away Kataro Taniguchi. Poland trying to hold on for silver. Australia for bronze, but Simbine with a great final 40 meters will edge out Australia for a bronze medal. But it will be Japan in a time of 39.08 meters. There you see their exchange. Poland did not have the cleanest exchange, but they will still finish second, taking the silver medal. South Africa wins bronze. Now the women's 4x400-meter relay. Tough to set Universiad records here with conditions like this. Universiad record in this event was set back in 1983 in Edmonton, Canada, a time of 3 minutes, 24.97 seconds. And as they come down the final straight, Poland, with Justyna Sweetie here on the anchor leg, win gold. Russia takes silver, the United States bronze. Malgorzata Holub of Poland, who won the 400 meters already here in Guangzhou, is a double gold medalist here at Universiad. And finally from last night, the men's 4x400 meter relay. And there you see a false start in lane one. Botswana's Lianame Mautoanong, and he is disqualified. So that leaves seven teams still to compete. Russia are the two-time defending gold medalists in this event. And for the Dominican Republic, Ludwin Santos, who won gold already here in Guangzhou in the 400 meters, he's the Olympic silver medalist at that distance. Dominican Republic in lane three, and there you see Santos well out in front. They will win gold in a time of 3 minutes, 5.05 seconds. Japan wins their second relay medal of the night, a silver here, and Poland takes the bronze. From last night, the women's gold medal match in football from the Nadju Public Stadium. France and Russia. France are the defending gold medalists from Kazan, while Russia has only won a bronze medal as an independent country. The USSR won gold in 1987. Early on, there's a stop from Amandine Guérin, stopping Choloviaga. And here, Ekaterina Dimitrenko with a turnover to Laura Bourguin of France, but she is stopped by Russian keeper Kokneva. And there you see the rain literally coming in sideways here in Guangzhou. Tsubudovic here with a free kick on target, but easily stopped by Guérin. Now to the 68th minute. Here's Bourguin. Comes right out and a great pass in front to substitute Valérie Gauvin. And France with a 1-0 lead. Much to the delight of their supporters. You see here off that throw-in, a great turn by Bourguin. And then a perfect little pass, and Gauvin makes no mistake. Russia, though, here with a chance. Chernomoderna just cannot control it. And the ball sails wide of the net. Corner now for France. And the header doesn't work, but it's chipped in, an own goal. Lyubov Kibiatkova of Russia inadvertently chips it past her own keeper. Just trying to clear it. And instead, it's now a 2-0 France lead in the 83rd minute. Unfortunate mistake there by Russia. And that is it. France, for the second straight Universiad, are gold medalists. Russia will win the silver. And Japan are bronze medalists in women's football. In a game from last night at the Dongkang College Gymnasium, it's Japan taking on Russia in the women's bronze medal basketball final. Japan coming off a tough double overtime loss to the United States, while Russia lost 70-60 to Canada. We'll pick it up in the fourth quarter, 56-46 in favor of Russia. Shinozaki penetrates there, but she's blocked, as you can see, by Medvedeva. Now Russia, good job here. They'll work the ball inside and then right back out. And Daria Namo will fire away for three and knock it down. Russia up 13. Now Shinozaki with the tough little runner in traffic. 61-50, under 6 minutes to go. Fina Gentineva will drive the lane and then she'll kick it back out to Tikhonenko and she'll knock down the three. Now Kairi Kondo of Japan. Nice little shot fake and the jump shot for her to keep Japan in it. Japan now down 12. They'll generate the turnover here. Japan, such a quick team. And Fujioka with the open look at three. It's well short, but Honda will clean up the rebound on the tough spin layup there for her. And Japan to within 10. 2.5 to go. Olga Novikova there. Nice spin, and she'll pull up at the free throw line for the jump shot. And time will run out on Japan. One last shot here. That one's short. And Russia will win the bronze medal 71-60 over Japan. They're led by Victoria Medvedeva with 14 points and 6 rebounds. We also had men's volleyball, the gold medal match last night between Russia and Ukraine from the Uomju Gymnasium. Russia is seeking their fourth straight gold medal, while Ukraine is seeking its first ever gold. Here in the first set, Zhigalov serves. Initially a bad pass there by Ukraine, but here Sergei Tyutlin off the block and out. Tied at 23. Great defense there by Russia. And Tyutlin from the back row, but he's got a foot on the attack line. That'll be a point to Russia. Now Igor Kliuka to serve for the set, but that one's well long. We're back tied again at 24. Now for Russia. Great job there by Ukraine. Maxim draws with the block. So a set point again for Ukraine. But this time it's Alexander Markin off the Ukrainian block. And that one lands in. Set point now for Russia. Bit of confusion here, but draws had his foot over the center line. So that'll give a point to Russia and the set. Go ahead now to the fourth. Russia up 2-1. They've just lost their first set of this tournament at Universiad in the third, 25-21. Ukraine sets up Moroz, but that attack goes wide. Now Dmitry Kovalev with a low serve there, and Ukraine can't handle it. Russia now up 13-6. Moving on now to match point, 24-14. And there's Kliamar from the back row. But that hit is long, and Russia has won its fourth straight men's volleyball gold medal at Universiad. Ukraine wins silver, and Argentina claims the bronze medal. We jump back to the rainy Sunday we had here in Gwangju for Taekwondo contest, 4 gold medal finals. The first one, the men's under 63 kilo class. Jawad Akab of Belgium and Zhao Shui of China meeting each other here for gold. Akab's already had a pretty solid 2015, having won gold at the World Championships, while Zhao had a successful Worlds himself, winning the bronze medal there. Akab in blue and Zhao in red. Akab would lead 2-1 after the first round and 5-1 after the second. So it would take a big effort from Zhao to get back into this contest in the third round. But he can't get close enough. 8-5 the final. Akab wins gold, Zhao the silver. And there you see the Belgian flag waving. Jackson and Huang each win bronze. Now the women's under 53 kilo class. Korea's Kim Min-jung up against Chinese Taipei's Huang Yun-wen. Huang won silver at this year's World Championships and also a gold medal at last year's Asian Games here in Korea. Huang would actually lead 1-0 after the first round, but a huge second round for Kim, where she would outscore her opponent 7-0 to lead 7-1 heading into the third and final round. And it'll end up 8-4. The home favorite Kim Min-jung wins gold, Huang silver. Helinda of Indonesia and Gladovic of Serbia take bronze medals. Back to the men. This time the under 87 kilo class. In blue, Inkyo Don of Korea, taking on Omid Amedi in red of Iran. And the Iranian faithful cheering him on. This will be even through the first two rounds with Amedi leading 2-1. He would actually be tied after the third round and go to a fourth. And in the fourth round, Amedi will score the point to win. In, very disappointed there, but he has nothing to be ashamed of. A silver medal. Uguz and Kiao take bronze medals home. Now the final one from last night. The women's under 73 kilo class. Featuring two athletes that have already successfully won medals at this year's World Championships. Eva Rados of Croatia won a bronze, while Zheng Shuyin took home a silver medal. There'd be no score in the opening round. Zheng would go up 2-0 in the second round. Now here in the third, you see there it's 3-0. She will score one more point, and it'll end 4-0 here. And there you see the umpire stepping in. Eva Rados falls to Zheng Shuyin. Bronze medals going to Uginc and Aiden. From last night at the Jongsong Hangeldong Gymnasium here in Gwangju, it's women's doubles table tennis, the gold medal match. This features from China, Chei Zhaoji and Jiang Yue, and from Chinese Taipei, Cheng Yiqing and Li Yichen. You can see right now we're in the sixth game. China ahead 3-2. And now on match point for China. That one into the net from Chinese Taipei, and Chei and Zhang win the gold medal. Their second of these games, Cheng and Li, they won silver on the women's team. They will take silver here. John and Yang of Korea and Kitaoka and Shoji of Japan each win bronze. Over next to the men's doubles gold medal match. This features Cheng Hung Che and Huang Sheng Sheng of Chinese Taipei, taking on Masataka Morozono and Yuya Oshima of Japan. We pick it up in the fifth game. Chinese Taipei up 3-1, but trailing 5-4 here. They tie it there, now equal at 5. And that forehand into the net for the Japanese. Chiang and Huang are the defending doubles gold medalists from Kazan. And here they are, 1 point away from winning gold again, and there they get it. Chiang and Huang defend their gold medal from 2013. Morozono and Oshima win silver. Chen and Liu from China and Jiang and Kim from Korea each win bronze medals. You see a look outside the Hwasan Hanyeom Sports Center, the site of badminton at Universiade here in 2015. This is the men's gold medal final featuring two Koreans, Jun Hyuk Jin and Sun Won Ho. Both of these two players already won gold on the mixed team earlier on here at Universiade. Jun would win the opening game 22-20. And right now we're tied up at 12. Later on here in the second game, 18-16 now, Jun ahead. And he comes to the net there for the smash. puts him 2 points away from gold. Now at match point. And that one out from Sun. And Jun Hyuk Jin of Korea, the gold medalist in men's badminton. Silver to Sun Won Ho. Chu and Su, each of Chinese Taipei, win bronze. Now the women's doubles gold medal match. This one is between Lee So-hee and Shin Suk-chan of Korea, and U Dong-ni and Yu Zhao-an of China. Lee and Shin both won gold in the mixed team competition, while Shin also won gold in mixed doubles. These two won bronze together in 2013 at Universiade in women's doubles, and then gold as part of the mixed team. The Koreans win the opening game 21-16. And here they're now 1 point away from gold. China to serve, and that smashed right at the Chinese player. And that will end it. 21-13 in the second game. They win this match 2-0 to win gold. U and Yu win silver. Kasahari and Kato of Japan and Go and Yu of Korea each win bronze. Now to the men's doubles final, featuring Korea's Kim Gi-jung and Kim Sarong, who are up against Wang Yil-yu and Zhang Wen of China. Kim Gi-jung is already a double gold medalist here in Guangzhou, having won gold in the mixed team and mixed doubles. He actually did that for the second straight Universiade, a feat that he also accomplished in 2013 in Kazan. The Koreans win the opening game 21-16. You're looking here at match point in game two. Great rally here from both teams and a diving effort there, but China will tie it up at 20. Now match point again for the Koreans. And a little bit of controversy here. That one is actually called out, giving the point to Korea and ultimately the match. Of course, China feeling that landed clearly in. And they're looking for additional support from one of the officials. And you'll see a close-up of it here, as that birdie clearly lands in. And you hear there from umpire Tahiko Tsujinaka of Japan, it was called out, and that's the call that stands. Korea wins gold in men's doubles, 2-0. Wang and Zhang win silver. And the teams from Thailand and Malaysia win bronze.